giving you an opportunity to get the full story from the people who tell it best. This is Mediacom News Leaders.
I'm Don West, and this is Mediacom News Leaders. We're joined now by Jerald Andrews, the president and executive director of the Missouri Sports Hall of Fame. Jerald, welcome to you, sir.
Thank you. Good to be
warmer
with you.
Weather is finally here, and
finally here.
A lot going on with the Missouri Sports Hall of Fame, and it starts with a golf tournament on May 14th.
It does. The fairways are greening up finally. Our annual Lake of the Ozarks Celebrity Golf Classic will be May 14th. That's played at the very elite club at Portachima. Not many people get a chance to play that golf course, so we've had a tournament there for the last several years. Continues to be a big hit. And we have a morning round and an afternoon round. Team space is still available in the morning. The afternoon is full.
One of the biggest events coming up of the spring months is the annual Missouri Sports Hall of Fame Baseball Luncheon, and that comes up May 24th.
It does. This will be our 23rd year to host our baseball event. We'll be inducting Rick Ann Keel. We'll be inducting the St. Louis Browns, looking forward to recognizing that great organization. The late Howard Bell will be inducted that day as well, along with Coach Mike Essex from Ozark and the Ozark baseball program. In addition, we'll be inducting Centralia softball coach Jill Angel that day. She's won four state titles in 19 years. And as always, we'll be honoring the Diamond Nine that day as well.
That's 11 a.m. at University Plaza Convention Center, downtown Springfield on May 24th, the baseball luncheon from the Missouri Sports Hall of Fame once again. You got some shrimp that are going to be involved in this in June.
We do. For once again, 23 years, we've had a party and an auction on the first Sunday evening of June. It's the Shrimp Social and charity auction. That'll be at the Oasis Convention Center. We have a large auction. We'll be eating shrimp that night. One of the really fun things we do is we play one game of blackout bingo, and the winner wins a prize of $1,000 cash. So that's always a lot of fun. That's in conjunction with our annual Springfield Celebrity Golf Classic that is played on Sunday morning, June 3, and all day Monday, June 4, two rounds on Monday morning and afternoon. That's at Highland Springs Country Club. It's one of the oldest, one of the largest charity golf events held in Springfield each year. And we still have some space available in that event also.
And another golf tournament coming early June as well?
Early June, mid-June, June 21 will be at Buffalo Ridge in Branson. For the last 9 years, we've managed an event for the Upper White River Basin Foundation. They are responsible for the clean water initiatives throughout the Upper White River Basin area. And this event's called the Ozarks Water Watch Golf Classic. And once again, June 21, they'll be at 1 o'clock at Buffalo Ridge. Great event, a great opportunity to play one of the finest golf courses in this part of the state.
And the big one coming up now, late July this year, July 26th through 29th, the annual Price Cutter Charity Championship. And that's it's moved to July and is probably going to stay there now?
That's our understanding. It appears we'll be in July. They've developed a great Midwest route for the players. They'll be playing in Omaha, Springfield, and then Kansas City. And so it'll be really a good time for the professionals to stay here in the Midwest. Our activities actually begin as early as June 25. I think our last event is on October 13. but July 20 through 30 is the 10 days of really intense activities. And as you mentioned, professional play July 26 through 29.
This baseball luncheon on May 24th is special to me. I was dear friends with Howard Bell, as were so many other baseball people in Springfield in this area, and he was just a fantastic guy.
Great guy. We're so pleased to have a chance to recognize him and what he did for baseball, the sport of baseball, as well as softball here in especially southern Missouri. His wife and family is quite excited about this, and a lot of his friends are turning out. It's going to be a great event.
And Mike Essex and the Ozark program.
It will. Once again, a couple of state titles. Been to the state championship tournament many times, and just what a great program here in Missouri.
That is coming up on May 24th at 11 a.m. at University Plaza Convention Center, the Missouri Sports Hall of Fame's annual baseball luncheon. The Diamond Nine will be recognized then, too, and that's a great program through the Hall of Fame as well. All good stuff. Go online to mosportshalloffame.com for information about all of these events coming up in the spring and summer months through the Missouri Sports Hall of Fame. Jerald, thank you as always,
thank you.
Sir.
Good to be here.
And join us next time here on Mediacom News Leaders.